Praise the Lord, precious saints, and welcome to another daily prophetic utterance to start your day. The Lord is saying today, my child, look to me for your identity. Do not look to the world, to the lust of the flesh, to the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. This world is deteriorating, my child, but look unto me for your hope and for your substance this day. The world is lost and continually changing its standard, and if you keep trying to fit in, it will only become exhausting for you to keep trying to pursue the world's ways. I am the only one that really knows who you are. For everything I create is something and not a nothing. I created you, and the one who creates you knows you better than everybody else. I created you very unique to all others. Yes, I love you with all your quirks and differences. I delight in you. You have my unequaled and undenying devotion and love. You are good enough. You are valuable. And to that person who has lost a job and cannot find another, to that one who has been trusting God for marriage and or a child, to that one who has lost a loved one and best friend, to that one who has been trusting in me for healing and breakthrough, to that one who has been waiting for me to come through hoping that things will only get better, to that one who is asking for encouragement and strength, to the one who's seeking direction in life, to the one who's seeking family unity in the midst of great division, I can make the impossible possible. Yes, the enemy is confronting you with your past and assailing you with thoughts of hopelessness and despair. I say to you that nothing shall separate you from my love, and nothing shall separate you from the outcome that I have promised. Every promise in my word is yes and amen in your life, because you know that you are called according to my purpose. What man threatens you is of no relevance. What the circumstances say is a lie. At times you feel like you are in a prison because you find it hard to accept who you are. You are so gifted and talented, though at times you have become blinded to see anything good within yourself, and therefore won't express yourself at times because of fear and rejection. You have allowed the fear of man to control you and have feared what people would think. I want to love you, but even at times you hold me at arm's length and won't let me really love you the way you need because you have been hurt by others. Yes, you fear that I will even reject you because of your weaknesses, like people have before, but I will never reject you. I love you with a deep unconditional love, so stop trying so hard to be accepted by me and realize I accept you where you are. I don't want you to be perfect. I'm not expecting a perfect performance. No, I want you to know that I love you. And yes, because my word has promised it so. Therefore, what others think from their unbelieving perspective has no bearing on what happens next in your life. For I have called you to walk in faith. Remember, I am the God of the impossible. What man cannot do and what you cannot change is as nothing to me. Forget all the conditions and circumstances that seem to weigh so heavily against you this day. What I have promised will surely be your portion. As you relinquish the outcome and anchor your hope in my word, then you will never be ashamed or come to failure. Yes, I have removed every man-made limitation that has been placed upon you. Every rod of condemnation is being broken from your life. Every limit of slander and accusation is being burned off in my presence right now, even of your destiny. Everything, every word of rejection
rejection is being rendered powerless. Powerless over your life, your destiny and identity. Every religious spirit that has prohibited my spirit's flow and denied my power in your life is being silenced. And its false authority is being laid bare. Take on the measureless. Take on the limitless clothing of my spirit, my love, my faith, my word. Awaken, feel the rain, feel the unfailing flood of my spirit pouring upon you. There is new praise being born in your mouth. With all your breath, give yourself to it. There is a washing away. The washing is a visitation of wholeness, wholeness that cannot be touched or moved, for my glory is unveiling it all. For you are untouchable in my light. I am a shield of favor around you. I will make you glad according to the days that you have been afflicted. Yes, and years that have seen evil, I will turn around and use for your glory. My works and majesty will appear before you. Continue walking in my love, and let the love thing be your first response to every disappointment and every challenge. Refuse to allow resentment to enter into your emotions. Reject all bitterness and self-hatred. You are accepted in my love. Yes, you are accepted, my beloved. You are the apple of my eye. My watch cares over you is unfailing and consistent all the time. Purpose to press into the righteousness, peace, and joy that is in my kingdom. I will bring you to the place where everything you say and do becomes as effective as I said it or did it. You will not be brought to shame because you dared to hope and dared to believe for better things. I am the God of renewed opportunity. Even where failure has dominated before, this is your hour. This is your time. Fear not, believing only, and you will see of the travail of your soul and be satisfied. I will make a way where there seems no way. I will make a road through the wilderness. I will bring a river through the deserts. Yes, I am that I am, and I will make a way for you. Fear not, for I am with you. You are not alone. Shalom.
Praise the Lord, precious saints. And when we turn to the book of Colossians chapter 2, verse 10, the Bible tells me, "And you have been made complete in Christ, who is the head over every ruler and authority." Somebody say amen. We have been made complete in Christ.
Many people that I have met suffer from the spirit of rejection, whether it's from the womb, from ancestral curses, or any type of abuse or abandonment. Many have been suffering their entire life from having even steady relationships or marriages, careers, and being able to serve God wholeheartedly. This requires not only deliverance, but also healing. Being renewed of your mind through the Word of God, as it says according to Romans 12 verse 2. Our minds need to be bound to Christ's ways of thinking and to God's Word. Several times a day, the enemy plagues our minds with negative thoughts and our flesh rises up. But that's why, according to 2 Corinthians 2 verses 4 to 5, it says, we take those thoughts captive under the obedience of Christ. Each and every thought must be taken captive and cast down. Rejection builds up when we don't take those thoughts captive and take ownership of such thoughts. Instead of casting the thoughts down, we take them in and allow them to build up strongholds into wrong thinking patterns. That's why I call it stinky thinking. Each time we own a thought and don't cast it down, it is part of a platform that we build inside of ourselves, creating a stronghold. We ourselves build up that rejection, and each and every thought that comes our way, we start to believe in those things. We must take ownership, not of the thought itself, but also removing of the thought. We have something to do about our situation. The choice, the decision is ours. Hallelujah. Now, when we're looking at King David, we read according to the Psalms of King David, whom God called a man after his own heart. You know that David was discouraged at many a times. And if you read Psalm 43, he begins to talk about his own overwhelming feelings of oppression and rejection, about all the problems he was facing and the sense of mourning. But then you see a sudden transition in his prayer. It's as though he stops in his tracks, turns around, and begins to challenge the very discouraging voice that's coming against him. He challenges those negative situations with eyes that begin to focus on God dwelling on his holy mountain and God who is David's joy and delight. He says, "Why am I discouraged? Why is my heart so sad?" Then he declares, I will put my hope in God. I will praise him and again my Savior and my God. I believe that David is showing us that any of us can go down the road of discouragement through negative self-talk, and it will hold us prisoner if we let it take us captive. The only way that we can break the chain is to begin to believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus is your Savior and God and your joy and delight. And then you will start to also give him praise and worship. You must take those thoughts captive. As true for David, the enemy will try to distract you from what God says about you. He wants to hear what other people are saying and to detect and distract you in those circumstances. He might say something like, "Hey, your bills are piling up. Your finances are running low." The enemy wants you to say, "Oh God, look, I'm so poor." But God says, "Let the weak say, I am strong," according to Joel 3 verse 10. Why? Because it's a principle that's been established by God. What you confess out of your mouth and what you believe in your heart will supersize your power. It will plug you into the greatness of God. Now, according to Ephesians 3 verse 20, it says, "Now to him who is able to exceedingly abundantly above all we ask and think, according to the power that works in us." God is able to do something great in you. It doesn't say according to God's power or according to if God is happy with me. It says according to what I release and increase on the inside of me. You can walk in great power and you can overcome every obstacle. You can climb every mountain and you can get out of every valley. You don't have to be discouraged or defeated. You're not a victim. You are a victor because God lives inside of you. If you feel inadequate, if you feel worthless, if you feel rejected, then you did not get those ideas or thoughts from God, but you got them from the devil. So today you must be made whole in the name of Jesus Christ. Every evil foundation which your life has been built upon, it must receive deliverance by fire today in the name of Jesus Christ. Every rejection that is older than you but is affecting you, release you today and die in the name of Jesus Christ. Inherited rejection, generational rejection, foundational rejection that is following your life all about, we shake it off today in the name of Jesus Christ, that it must be released from you. Lord, I pray today the yoke of collective rejection afflicting their lives, it must break and die in the name of Jesus Christ. Rejection, Lord, that has gone into their genes, we cut it off by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. Oh God of the suddenlies, arise and quicken their spirits and favor upon their lives in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, we pray today that even in their dream life, it must receive fresh fire, fresh anointing, anointing, fresh revelation in the name of Jesus Christ. Every curse of rejection running within their family lines that has overshadowed their blessings must break now in the name of Jesus Christ. Miracles that will promote them. Lord, I pray that they would locate them today in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, where their job has been, Lord, I pray where they've been rejected in the job, let it be loosened today and you will loosen your blessings upon them in the name of Jesus Christ. Let multiplication anointing graduate to explosive anointing within their life in the name of Jesus Christ. We know that by the blood of Jesus, we come out of every satanic prison in the name of Jesus Christ. It shall, and we shall see an end today. We shall see an end of us, and that Christ who lives within us shall receive all the glory. Lord, I pray today you will come and speak to your people. You will visit them. You will touch them from the top of their heads to the soles of their feet. They are loved. They are cherished. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, when they see themselves in the reflection of the mirror, they will say that I am God's creation. I am the apple of his eye. I am part of his handiwork. Lord, I pray and declare today, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, you will bless each person today from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrow Paths Ministries in Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom. And if you've liked this utterance today, I encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you haven't already, you can follow us on Facebook on our official page. You can also follow us on Instagram. You can find all those links in each of the description sections. I encourage you also, I'm also going to put our morning spiritual prayer and our night spiritual prayer as links within the description. I encourage you to play them every morning and every night, because we've had so many testimonies of people that have said as they have played those in their house each day, the Lord has changed the environment of their homes for their unbelieving, saved loved ones. So I encourage you to do that so that you can get praise, get warfare. And we always back up everything in our prayers with scripture. So we'll encourage you to play scripture in your household. Don't forget, this weekend is our 3-day fasting, 26th to the 28th, precious saints. Make sure that you plan to participate and try to rally up some people to join you. And don't forget to write down all your prayer requests, place them in the Bible, and let's see God move on your behalf. So from my family to yours, God bless you. We love you. We are praying for you, precious saints. Shalom, shalom, shalom.